Proper feeding is directly related to survival of your chickens. For maximum performance and good health, your chickens need a steady supply of energy, proteins, essential amino acids, minerals, vitamins, and most importantly, water.
In every poultry house, you need different equipment for poultry. That's, you need the drain cars, you need the feeders, you need the readiness if they are mature like this for hatching, you need the patches and pallets for feed. So to start with, we have the feeders for feeding the chicken. We are using long trough Juakari feeders. At the top, it has a rod. The chicken cannot perch on that rod because it's roaring. It's supposed to be roaring. Then the iron sheet is turned inside. So to avoid the wastage of the feed. Yeah. Then from there we have drinkers. For us, in our case, they are automated. To some extent, you can use the 20 liter jerry can or this automated. With these automatic drinkers, they are good because you don't keep refilling the water. You just need a top tank, then through gravity, they fill themselves. With one drinker, can serve around 50 to 100 chicken.
What I'm doing now at the moment is that because of the environment around, there is a sawdust, and these cuckoos will always scratch and put the sawdust in the water. By removing this way, fresh water will come and the sawdust will come down. That's trying to keep the water clean.
Poorly fed birds have low immunity. Never leave them hungry. Imbalances in nutrition leads to stunted growth and high mortality, especially in the chicks. It is for this reason that you should include food supplements. Provided with the right conditions, an indigenous hen will lay her first egg at 28 weeks. Remember, water should be provided at all times to the layers. Feeding should be on clean, hygienic conditions.